This is session 3, Create a Library. Media management totally changed with this version of Final Cut Pro 10. Events were replaced by libraries. Also gone are the Final Cut Events and Final Cut Projects folders. The purpose of this movie is to provide an overview on managing libraries. A library stores media, events, and projects. Libraries can be stored anywhere. And when you first create a library, there's no media in it, only a single event. There's no limit to the number of media clips, events, or projects that can be stored in one library. Libraries are portable provided all media is stored inside the library, what we call managed media. And libraries can be opened, closed, or backed up at any time. However, you must always have at least one library open at all times. So let me show you how to create a new library, how to open an existing library, how to close an existing library, and how to find a library in the Finder. Keep in mind that you move a library from one location to another using the Finder. Before I start Final Cut, I want to illustrate something I've done on my second drive. I've created a folder called Final Cut Libraries. Now, the name of this folder is totally irrelevant. You could call it anything you want, but I like obvious, so I called it Final Cut Libraries. Notice here, there's my Final Cut Events and Final Cut Projects folders from earlier versions of Final Cut. But with libraries, I've created a single folder. Now, it's entirely possible I could have a library which is so big it needs to span multiple hard drives. Well, you'd actually create multiple libraries in that case. But most of the stuff I edit can fit to a single hard drive. I like knowing where my libraries are stored, so I've created the Final Cut Libraries folder. Keep in mind, libraries can be stored anywhere, named anything, in any folder. Let's go to Final Cut. At this point, I only have one library open. If I wanted to create a new library, go up to the File menu, go down to New, a Library. It says, what do you want to call it, and where do you want to store it? I'm going to call this Dance Recital. And I'm going to specify that I want it stored inside the Final Cut Libraries folder. Click Save, and three things happen at once. The new library shows up in the library's list. That's what this window is called, the library list. It automatically creates a single event because a library must have at least one event in it, and it's ready to import media. I've created the container, but there's nothing in it yet. I'm going to highlight the event and just press the Enter key and call this My First Event. Well, we'll leave it there because we're going to have a movie that talks about events in just a second. But let's go back to Dance Recital and right mouse click on it or go up to File. And notice that I have a choice. It says Close Dance Recital. Well, let's go up to File and let's open a library. It knows all the libraries that I've created. So I want to open up Dr. Surf. And do another thing, right mouse click inside the library list. I can close Dr. Surf. Let's go back up, open library, model trains. I don't have to quit Final Cut to be able to swap media in and out. There always has to be one library open. There always has to be one event inside the library. But creating a new library is as easy as going up to File, New Library. And there's no limit to the number of libraries that I can create. And here's another cool thing. If I right mouse click directly on glass blowing, see it says Reveal in Finder? It opens up the Finder folder that contains that library and highlights it so that I can see exactly where that library is stored. And there's the other libraries that I've stored inside the Final Cut Libraries folder. Again, libraries can be stored anywhere on any hard disk in any folder using any name. I'm just being really obvious because it means I don't have to think about where I stored it. Libraries are the foundation of media management in Final Cut Pro 10. They are more flexible and capable than events were in earlier versions of Final Cut. We'll learn a lot more about libraries in chapters 3 and 4. This has been an excerpt of our most recent Final Cut Pro 10 training covering workflow and editing. For the complete version of this online training, please visit our store at larryjordan.biz/store. and thanks.